Stormblade, and welcome to part 27 of the bathroom tutorial. We're going to start off by... What? I'm trying to fix this little mesh smooth thing we have going on here. Let's select all these edges here. Now we'll just try raising them a bit. No, that doesn't do it. Next, what we'll try is insetting this polygon. Ooh, that was it. Fixed that problem quite nicely. And finally, let's just target weld this little corner vert to here. And then do the same. Check it didn't royally mess anything up. No. We're good to go, I think. Just trying to see if the sides look the same. Could be just the shading, but I'm gonna delete it. Oh. That's interesting. Oh. Alright, just cap that. And I think it is just a black polygon. Just a shading thing. Soap holder, and then we'll let's see. Do I know it like this? No. All right, let's make this thing 7 inches long. So width of 7. Just like this, and just scale it down. All we're looking for is width. Alright, looks good. Delete. Let's give it a gray material again. Just going back and forth. And you can pretty much design not only a bathroom, but any part of a house using the same method. Just varies ever so slightly. Bring this up. Let's zoom in on this thing. Rotate it 180 degrees, it looks like. And sink it into the wall. Alright, next it's going to be 6 inches off the tub. So box, length 6. And make sure to save. And bring this down. Good. Next it's going to be 24 inches from the far wall over here. So rotate it 90 degrees. And put that in the wall. And bring this over to match. Alright. Delete. We now have our little soap holder. So we're actually starting to have something that looks like a bathroom. I'm just going to do a few minor tweaks here. Well, I hope they're minor. But select these two edges right here and just give them a chamfer. But don't make it very big. Just a little bit. And then give it about... segments, because we want a smooth corner, if you will. Go to the top viewport and can actually see that. We're just going to need to bring this out a tad, just so that it covers up the edges there. There we go. In fact, we're going to do the same with these two. So just give those a quick chamfer. Not quite so abrupt though. Smaller, so we need less segments. Four should do just fine. Then a similar chamfer over here. This is just preparing it for the eventual rendering. Because if you have corners that aren't aligned, or that are perfectly at right angles, it screws up the light. We're not going to do these corners in here, because there's going to be tiles going up the walls, and they come out a bit. So we're going to actually have to do some resizing eventually, but maybe I can wait for now. Next, I think we're going to do the shower bar, or the towel bar. So let me get some. Actually, yeah, I think I have one. I do. So go into the front here, Alt-B, Files, choose this one. Right, so it looks just like a shower bar thing. Select what you have, hide selection, cylinder. Make a cylinder the approximate size. Give this one about 30 segments, I'd say is a good number. Okay, there we go. Angle snap. It's being a little difficult there for a second. Convert it to an editable poly. Select what you need, which is the polygon. Alright, get out of the foreview momentarily. Okay, and then let's just scale it inward a bit, I think. Even a bit more. There we go. And just press OK. Next we're going to bring it out a bit to about here, and then scale it back up. I'm not sure how many things I used, so just control click, deselect, and then control, deselect. Let's count how many we have in between here. 2, 7, so 1, 2, 3, 4. Click that one. That one, that one, let's try every two. We're not going to follow our plan exactly, but chances are this won't even work, knowing me. Oh, it did, what do you know? So, inset those. Okay, and then extrude them. Okay. Next, select this polygon here, extrude. Okay, inset it a bit. Then extrude. Next, what you're going to do is delete that. Select this, bring it out. Okay, rotate it 180 degrees. So, attach, and then select all these verts here, scale them inward, weld, should all weld together, and now you'll have a perfect extendable post, if you will.